Everybody, if you remember from previous video, whenever we rerun application, we need to enter the phone number and we need to enter the person I want to track. And this is not what we want. We want to someone close the app and reopen it. Everything is saved. Either when the phone is restarted, the app will start with boot up, so the data will be loaded again. So you need to save the data. I will save the data through the shared reference. So let me go to the GitHub, and from GitHub try to go to the snippet code in the file, find my phone. I would go to the snippet code, and from snippet code I will take the new code that I have, is this one for a global file. From this one to this one, I just copy them and I add them in this file and family finder. So what this code mean? First of all, I will define context because I need to access to some layout design from normal class. Also, I will define shared reference. Then in the constructor of the global info, I initialize the context and also initialize the shared reference file and a grid file, name it my phone. I grid two method, one method for save. I need to save the data. Which information I will save? I will save phone number and my tracker. So first of all, my tracker is the map, so I need to change them to string to store them. So I will get for loop to move through all the trackers. Then I will get them one by one. I will get phone number and the username on all these. I will list them and I will add between them this sign between phone number and username on all the users. I will add them through the list. When I will done, I OK. If I don't have any item in my tracker list, I will add empty in this variable. Then I will save tracker. This list, I will add it, save it. Then I will add number of phone number also, I'll save it. Then I comment the save for me. Next, when someone we want to load the data, that's great. First of all, I will create the tracker. I will get phone number. I added here from the file. I will get tracker list and add there. But tracker list, if you see, we save it between them one sign. So I need just to check if there is tracker is not empty. I will just get all the users and split them according to this sign that we add them. Then I will add them again to the tracker list again by adding first and second. That means I'm adding key and username, key and username, key, username. But if you see here, I'm not increasing by one. I have to increase i equal i plus two because I need to move I don't need to move one location, because when every user have two location in the array, having phone number and username. After I get the information, that's great. If there is no phone number, that means the person is loading for first time or open the app for first time, I will navigate to the page, name it context. If you see here, I'm using context. Here I'm using context or start activity, because you cannot write directory start activity from class normal class. You could write start activity only from activity class. So this is normal class, so you cannot do it. So you have to add context. Therefore, we pass it context. So make sure whenever you use anything like start activity or another, you have to write context. Also, you have to add this flag when you want to start activity from normal class. That's great. So what I have to do now? Now I want my application is not starting from login. My application will start from the main page. That's great. In the main page, when the app starts from main activity, I want to check if I'm loading the data. When the activity started, I need to load the data. So what I will do, I create an instance from global info, and I'll try to load the data. What will happen? He will come here, and he try to load the data. If he did not see phone number, he will pop the activity for login for us. The activity for login will appear, and when he click next, I have to finish this activity. Then I will open next activity, that is a tracker. He would select number of trackers. So when he select them, he will do some operations. For example, I want to save. I want to save when someone, let me first save the data when someone add tracker. So when he add someone track him, I will save file. So I will save this in the file. When he delete someone from tracker list, also I want to save them in the file. Just to make sure. Also, if he did not select anyone to track him, I want also, if you just click go back, I also save the data in the file. Before I run it, let me check last thing in the global info file. If you see, when I save as name as my tracker, but when I read here, I should read it as my tracker. Also, when I load it, I load phone number and I all the data saved in the tracker list. That's great. Tracker and I load the trackers. That's great. But when I load phone number, I don't have variable just in this way. So before you run it, just make sure you go back and you remove your tracker app to make sure you will not have any problem when you run it again. Then rerun and see the result. Here we go. He asked me for a device. I give phone number now. 5957-2732. Next, I'm adding someone to track me. I will add myself, tracking myself, and that's good. Now, what's the new thing is happened? The new thing, if you close the app, let me just close it and try to reopen the app again. He will not to go to Logan and other stuff. He already have all the information saved. Here we're done, and thank you for watching.